3D printing technology saved a woman's life who fell down the stairs and fractured her skull. From Frankenstein to Robo Girl, it definitely was a long road to recovery. I'm gonna tell you her story here for you on IO. Welcome back to Inform Overload. My name is Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more stories about incredible people you won't believe exist. I just wanted to take a moment to let our subscribers know that we have set up a Patreon account. For those that don't know what Patreon is, it's a way that you can support our channel by donating as little as $2. If you want to donate a little more, there's definitely perks. IO, like many news channels, can't always cover everything in the news because many topics will get demonetized. If you enjoy our channel and would like to see more topics and more videos on the weekend, click the link to our Patreon in the description and donate. Thanks in advance! Francesca Burr was a model and artist. When she was 27 years old, she suffered a seizure and fell down the stairs at her mother's home. The fall left her with 5 skull fractures, a broken nose, and a cracked jaw. She was discovered at the bottom of the stairs by her mother and stepfather, who came home from dinner and couldn't open the door because Francesca's body was blocking it. She had blood coming out of her eyes, ears, and nose. Once she got to the hospital, she was in a coma for over a month. Her parents were told to prepare for the worst. Francesca had to endure 3 operations where doctors removed tiny bone fragments from her brain. She also suffered from severe memory loss. When she woke up, she couldn't remember her boyfriend or the fact that her parents had been divorced for 10 years. Francesca couldn't even remember her middle name. A large chunk of her head was missing, and there was basically a huge hole in her skull. But thanks to 3D printing technology, doctors were able to fix a titanium plate to Francesca's skull. 10 months after the fall, she is now in recovery. Francesca says her experience was like going from Frankenstein to Robo Girl. Her brother even said that when she was in recovery, she looked like Frankenstein, which is funny because her name is Francesca. Her words, not mine. I'm not making fun of her. The sad truth is, Francesca will never be the same. Her brain is held together by metal pins. She struggles daily with her mental health, and she doesn't even have a social life anymore. But things are getting back to normal little by little. Now that her hair is growing back, you don't really notice the hole as much. While Francesca was in the hospital, she met a guy who she's still dating to this day. Good luck to Francesca on her road to recovery. That is all for that story. Just wanted to update you on the story about Selena Gomez's kidney transplant. A lot of articles have been coming out about Selena's best friend, Francia Reza, who donated her kidney. Apparently, she was seen back at work already on September 15th, so it's clear her recovery was successful. Here's a link to the original story for you guys, and I'll see you in that video.